Hey, what's up YouTube? Today I'm gonna be talking about which is the ideal bench press angle because most guys bench without really understanding which angles are best for their particular goal. It's also important to understand that all benching angles actually target the same muscles. Changing angles doesn't mean a whole new set of muscles are being targeted. What does change is the degree of activation between muscles. All of this is crucial if you wanna grow certain areas more or desperately need to offset your man boobs. Before I get into all the research, I just wanted to point out that all the studies unanimously agree on which angles are best for the triceps and the shoulders. For the anterior delt, the front of the shoulder, the more angle you have, the better. Meaning the more inclining you get, the more the shoulders activate. This is why an incline press or even a full standing press nails the shoulders far more than a flat bench press. For the triceps, the flat bench press is most ideal. In research terms, this is a 0-degree press, and any incline or decline away from this angle activates the triceps less. I was also able to find a study showing that if a certain angle takes work off the triceps, the biceps will get more involved. Some pretty neat stuff, but let's get into the important part that everyone cares about, which is how bench angles affect the chest. Guys are always looking for the best angle to hit their upper chest, as that is usually the flattest part of their pecs. It's also very commonly speculated that hitting the upper chest can help in offsetting man boobs, making them appear less boobish, I guess. The best solution for man boobs will always be a custom effective fat loss diet. However, training the upper chest definitely can still improve their appearance. Unfortunately, when it comes to training angles to hit the upper chest, research isn't completely unanimous, so let's break down all the data we do have. The pec major, aka the superstar chest muscle, is broken into two heads, the clavicular head, aka the upper chest, and the sternocostal head, aka the mid slash lower chest. The first study done in 1995 compared the angles of decline, flat, and incline. The mid slash lower chest was shown to activate the most on the flat bench press, followed by decline, then incline. For the upper chest, they concluded the clavicular head of the pec major was no more active during the incline bench press than during the horizontal one, but it was less active during the decline bench press. This basically states that the flat and incline were even when it comes to hitting the upper chest. The raw data on the study showed the incline actually was better for hitting the upper chest, but it was considered statistically insignificant, so we can't quite make that conclusion just yet. Let's move on to the next study in 1997. This one compared decline versus incline bench for both the lifting and lowering portion of the lift. The mid slash lower chest was greater in the decline, but activation for the upper chest was concluded the same. So far, it's looking like the incline bench angle actually doesn't do much, if anything at all, for the upper chest. But don't worry, let's look at more recent data and see if there's any merit to targeting the upper chest by going on an incline. This more recent study in 2010 showed the mid slash lower chest is activated the most on the flat bench followed by the decline bench, confirming earlier research about mid slash lower chest activation. The upper chest, however, was shown to activate more during the incline bench in this study, particularly at a 44-degree angle. The most recent study on this topic in 2016 focused only on the upper chest and actually measured activation within each portion of the lift. They concluded the results of this study support the use of a horizontal bench to achieve muscular activation of both the upper and lower heads of the pecs. However, a bench incline angle of 30 or 45 degrees resulted in greater muscular activation during certain time points. This study also showed the most significant upper chest activation in the second quarter of the lift. So for the shoulders, triceps, and mid slash lower chest, the answer is very unanimous. For the ever elusive upper chest region, the research isn't absolutely unanimous, but clear enough to show that an incline of about 45 degrees will probably make the most sense. If you want to hit the upper chest even more, you can target the scientific range of motion where they seem to activate the most, which is the second quarter of the lift. I recommend performing the incline bench press in a 1.5 style of training, where you lower the weight, press halfway up, lower the weight again, then perform a full rep. 1.5 reps will allow you to place more tension in the upper chest. In general, for most people, I recommend doing a combination of flat bench and incline bench, or switching between the two in between programs. As for the decline bench, it's also a great option as well, especially for hitting your chest while limiting shoulder involvement. But I personally am not a fan of it just because blood rushes down to my head and that's kind of uncomfortable for me. Regardless, I hope you found this video helpful. Please share and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. I will see you next time, YouTube. Peace.